Hi, I'm Rob from Hobbsing.com. Thanks for joining me for another video beer review. This time, joined by Adam from Adam's Craft Beer Channel and Stuart from the Ginger Ale Trail. And we've got a bottle of Horrell's Ode to Gurs Mega Blend. It's a 2013, so this is a collaboration between Driefontein and Boone. Oh, it's fucking Boone, I'm starting again. It's not Boone. I hate people calling it Boone. Not Michael Elphick, is it?
I call it Boone. Yeah, I keep it game.
Now, I'm joined by Adam from Adam's Craft, Rob from Hops India.
Right? This.
Every time.
What was that, Hops India?
Hops India.
Yeah, so there's an event every biannually. There's like a community of brewers, and they call the community like Orals, much like the.
It'll come to him.
It's essentially all the kind of like lambic brewers and blenders
yes.
get together for the Tour de Gurs.
Yes.
That's what he said. I didn't want to say it.
So, the members of the team together to make this every biannual event, which is Tour de Gurs, which is a celebration of lambic beers and stuff like that. And they use young and old barrels for this. This was kindly brought by one of the proprietors of Triangle, a local bottle shop, wouldn't that Rob frequents enough, and Rob and Adam. I put it on him.
And Rob.
Yeah.
Adam.
And me himself. But yeah, it's cool that brewers team together now and again just to do these unique beers.
Yeah.
This is the 2013, it's individually bottled, so it's rarely. Where did you buy this from?
Gav, where did you get it from?
A small beer shop in Leuven.
Okay.
The home of Stella Artois.
Hey,
oh, wow,
interesting. And I like the juxtaposition of buying a really kind of like exclusive lambic in
now, this is brewed at the Benin Brewery.
Okay.
Now, there's several breweries. We've all had at least one from the brewers.
Yeah, for sure. We've all reviewed one at least.
And they all specialise in different variations of Belgian style beers.
Yeah, well, the lambic producers, yeah. I mean, whether they're brewing it or just blending it, like for example, like Tilquin don't brew, but I think
Benin's
like Tinnemans, Lindemans, and like Oudebessel, I think they're I think Bone, they actually brew it, but there's Driefontein are essentially they're a blender.
Yeah, they're a major. They're in more supermarkets and stuff like that.
Bone.
And also the other one is Timmins. They do a lot.
Mm. A lot of fruit beers.
Yeah. But this is 7%. This is 2013. So it'd be like 2013, 2015, 2011, that kind of thing. There'll be one every year.
It's a pale golden beer.
It does have a nice amount of haze to it though, for a goose. I mean, some can be very, very clear, can't they?
Soppy whitehead.
Yeah.
As far as the aroma goes.
Whoa.
It's really different for me though,
it's different, but it's very white wine, don't you think?
Yeah.
It's like a dry white wine.
I get a lot of stuff that reminds me of something slightly lager-esque about it. It's kind of in the herbaceous way, I guess. Mm. You know what I mean?
It's a very lime juice kind of character for me, like a real like acidic lime sort of juice thing going on.
So I'm not sure how you ask for this when you're in a shop. Do you go into the shop and say, do you want oral? That's what I was trying to specify earlier.
Oh, brilliant. He's been working on that one for
ages. It's not as oaky as I kind of anticipated it to be. It's there. The oak's there. But
there's something kind of like shouted out for me, kind of like traditional German hops. It's like Herzbrucker or like Sartz or something like that. It's all that lemon. It's not that sharp kind of lemon juice.
Creamy cheese.
There is a cheesy character to it. I'm just going to get onto that. Yeah.
But I don't know if the old hops that you put in a lambic would be. They're like 3-year-old.
Yeah.
So
is it Sticky Bishop or something like that? That kind of aroma. It's got that really unique smell.
Yeah. I agree with the cheesiness.
Yeah.
It's something that you get off some Gurs and some triples as well. But yeah, let's get into it.
Yeah. Cheers. That's really nice. It's still kind of like, do you know sometimes you have sours and you just, I think, feel my kind of taste.
Shredded wheat.
Yeah.
Shredded wheat, warm milk. It tastes like that.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
It doesn't.
It does.
That's what I agree with that. That you've stolen.
No, because you get that really like wheat taste, but it's like a, almost lactose on the back end.
The acidity, probably lactobacillus.
There you go.
Which, like you're getting like a natural yogurt and stuff like that.
Yeah.
For me, it's a very kind of. Granted, it's a different body. It's more of a kind of champagne-y, kind of white winey body, like spritz it. But it's a cross between a Gers and a triple kind of yeastiness for me.
I know what you mean.
You know what I mean? There's that triple kind of dairy sweetness in it for me. I know it's the lactobacillus.
Gooseberry.
Yeah.
I'm getting kind of gooseberry.
Yeah. White grape.
Yeah, white grape.
White grapes for sure.
But it's not kind of like puckering, kind of like
no.
If you got like a Cantillon kind of like Gers, which you'd be like.
I mean, they do say that tomatoes are
not,
really
it's not
good for ages.
Is it? Yeah.
I mean, I think you spotted it. You can age it still until.
Get on. 2034 you can age this still. I mean, this is only 2013, so in that respect it's quite a fresh bottle.
For me it's got a really refined taste. It's not tart, it's not too sharp.
No.
Yeah,
it's just really mellow.
Yeah, it's so easy drinking as well, you know. Sometimes Gers can be a little bit hard going with the
acidity.
It's not, and it for 7%. Yeah, that's really well blended.
Beautiful stuff. Yeah.
But so, wow, thank you.
So that is a bottle of Orals, Only Gers Mega Blend 2013. Lovely stuff.
So don't forget to ask Oral when you're in Belgium.
See you next time. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah, I wonder whether it's. You know, because it's like homogenised, like milk is. Whether that